Hopefully you got an Ender 3 for Christmas. I've got one to put together for a family member. If you didn't, there's a link in the description below, including a link to my Filament Friday toolkit, which will go great with any 3D printer. But that's not what I want to talk to you about today. Prusa Slicer version 2.2 Alpha is out, and it includes a profile for Ender 3. Is that awesome? So let's check it out right here at Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. Here's a location where you can download it. I'll put a link to this in the description below so you can try it out for yourself. This is actually the second alpha release of the slicer, so they've been doing some work on this. And if you scroll down, you can read all about it. There's all kinds of information about version 2 and version 1. I'm using it on my Mac, so this is the link I use to download it. But here's the part that's exciting. It's now supporting third-party printers, and the first one that they're including, the Ender 3. How awesome is that? So let's take a look at it. I installed version 2.2 alpha, and for proof, I'll go here to help about Prusa Slicer, and there it is, version 2.2 alpha 2 plus. So now I'll go to configuration menu, configuration assistant, and here's where you can select the printer profile. There's already a bunch of Prusas in here, including the new Mini. But I'm going to go to other vendors, and there's a Creality box. I check that. Then Creality FFF shows up. I click on that, and there it is, the Ender 3 with a 0.4 nozzle. So I clicked on that, and I thought I was done, so I clicked on Finish, but it gave me a warning. I needed to set up at least one filament. So I'll just do a generic. So I'm going to select PLA and then generic PLA, and I'm ready to go. And once I did, look at this. The Ender 3 bed shows up in the Prusa Slicer. That is really cool. To the right are all the standard settings. You have your print settings, and this is your layer heights, 0.12, 0.20, 0.24, the generic PLA and Ender 3 profile that I selected. Now let's go to File and Import to bring in a file to print. So I'm going to import a .stl file, in this case, my CHEP cube. And there it is on the bed, and you can move it around just like any slicer. And you have that Ender 3 bed. Now let's go to print settings. I had already changed the layer height from 0.12 to 0.2 at that drop down, but I want to change the seam position. It was set to nearest, and now I want to make it random. So I'll click on that. Then I'll go to filament settings, and I found that the temperatures were way off. These were like ABS settings, not PLA. So I changed it to 205 and 205 to fit my Filament Friday filament, and the bed I made 50 degrees. So once that was set, then I could move on. Next, I looked at the cooling and there was no fan enabled, which would make sense if it's ABS, you don't want a fan. So I checked that box, but then it said 0% for the fan speed. So I just set the minimum to 100% because that's what I wanted. And then once I did that, this message, fan will always run at 0% except for the first three layers. That changed to 100% when I clicked on the next box. So that was good. So I went back to the main screen, and now I'm ready to slice it. So I sliced it, and it said it'd take 42 minutes and 48 seconds, and then I could scroll through the different layers. Everything looked fine, so now I was ready to print it on my Ender 3. So I saved it to my SD card, and now they have this little X that you click on that, and it will actually unmount the SD card, just like Cura does. I love that. So now let's just compare some prints. The one on the right is with my Cura 4.4 CHEP profile. The one on the left is a Prusa Slicer. It's definitely not as good. The profile needs to be updated and improved. But overall, for a first print off this thing, not too bad at all. There was definitely some sagging on the letters, so the bridging is not right. That fan isn't completely right. And the random produced some little nerds or bumps all over the print. That needs to be fixed. This is an early alpha, but I know it's just going to get better. I like the direction this is going. I think it's great that the Prusa Slicer now includes the Ender 3 in the machine profiles. And it makes sense from a business point of view, because if you get used to their slicer, you might want to buy one of their printers.